Oh shit, I didn't spin all the way around.
Listen, I know this video is super overdue, and I've tried to come up with a million ideas for my big celebration for a million subscribers, do something crazy or stupid or idiotic, or maybe a combination of the three, but nothing seemed better than just talking to you guys and showing my appreciation and kind of explaining how we got here. A lot of people don't actually know what the origin of this channel is, or what the origin of my place in the internet content arena is, and I kind of wanted to explain all that and just show my appreciation for you guys. Like 8 years ago, it's like 8 years ago, who the fuck cares? Like 8 years ago, I made a Facebook page. I know, my content started on Facebook, and probably a lot of you guys know that because that's how you found me, but my content started on Facebook, not YouTube. And for like, it was like a few months, if I remember correctly, maybe a few weeks, there was a period on Facebook where you could name a page, the title of it could just have no letters or numbers, it could just be symbols. And I was like, that's pretty funny. So as a joke, because I'm just the funniest guy, I thought, wouldn't it be cool if a page was just named a circle? You know, and I used a bullet point for the symbol, and it worked. And I made this little page about this little dot. It was before it was even named circle. It was called like a little, it was a little black dot. And I thought that would just be really funny. I started posting memes, and then eventually I started posting my own memes, and then eventually my own artwork, and cartoons, and comics, and yada yada. And I got a fan base of like, maybe like 10,000 people, or like 15,000 people. It wasn't huge, but it was huge to me. I mean, like, holy shit, that was crazy to me. That Facebook page was like everything to me growing up. I started making videos because they were getting shown more in the Facebook algorithm than pictures. So I jumped away from the memes and my comics, and I was like, I'll just make videos. Well, you know, what kind of videos can I make every day? Because I was posting content nearly every day. And I was like, what kind of content can I make almost every day and have it be art related? And I found this website that lets you draw the original Pokemon in 45 seconds. It has one little pop-up of the Pokemon you're supposed to draw, and that little blank canvas with like 8 simple colors. And it's a fun little game. You can see, you know, everyone's submissions at the bottom. And I used to play this with my friends anyway. And I was like, what if I made a video of me drawing my horrible abominations? And just recorded it and made commentary and tried to be a little goober.
Oh, hey guys, I'm back with another 45 second Pokemon drawing. And guess what? Today we're gonna do Ghastly. So first we're gonna, you know, draw the circle, which, you know, I'm a pro at circles, so, you know, this should be fucking easy.
That's what I fucking did. I made like a million of them. I made so many of these fucking videos. You know, circles, 45 second Pokemon drawings, or circles art tutorials. There was a lot of names for them. And I made like a million of them. And I got fucking sick of it. I was like, I'm tired of drawing Pokemon. I'm done with this shit. I love Pokemon, but I can't draw just Pokemon for the rest of my life until I'm made of bones. And, well, I'm still made of bones, but, you know, it's concealed. And, so eventually I was like, fuck it. I'll make a video that, is still in my same style. It's still filmed the same way, same commentary. But I'll draw the characters, and it'll be kind of like a slightly animated comic voiced in real time improv with my voice. That's how my tablet / MS Paint animation style videos came to be. And so it started with these 45 second Pokemon drawings, and I realized this is gonna go nowhere. Once I'm done all these Pokemon, like, what am I gonna do? So I transitioned to something where I had the freedom to make any storyline, any characters, any parodies, anything, as you guys know from this channel. It gave me the freedom to do what I wanted. I started doing videos like that, and they did okay. A lot of people on Facebook were mad at me because they were like, hey, where's the Pokemon art tutorials? And I was like, please, I want to die. And then I made my E3 in a nutshell, 2017.
Back, motherfucker, it's Nintendo, bitch! You said you wanted Metroid, you wanted Samus, we got two, motherfucker!
That video on Facebook got something like 35 million impressions, which aren't exactly, you know, views, but it got millions of views, but it exploded. It was like everyone was seeing it on Facebook. It got picked up by, I don't know, iFunny and 9gag, all those stupid websites, and everyone knew me for this style now. And like everyone forgot about the Pokemon stuff. And I was like, oh shit, dude, this is awesome. My YouTube channel was actually like my second home for content. I didn't really use it that much. My Facebook was meant for everything. And my YouTube channel had, I think, 900 subscribers when I posted, when I started posting the stuff that I was posting on Facebook to my YouTube channel. I started flooding this channel with my Facebook videos. And then like overnight, I got something like, I think 10,000 subscribers, which made my fucking brain melt out of my ears. And I was blown away, and I was like, damn, I could really have a following on YouTube. So I continued pursuing that style of video. You know, my crazy filming the tablet and drawing with one hand and filming, holding a camera in the other, and it gets wild when I make these videos. And I love it. I love making these style videos. I can do anything that I want with them, and they're fun to make, and you know, they're still like 95% improv, and that's a lot of fun for me. I don't really like writing scripts that often. I don't really like coming up with this concrete piece and then putting it out there. I kind of like just making characters, making the scenes, and just having the jokes and stupidity, you know, follow along naturally. So that's where we are with this channel. A lot of people don't know the origin of Circle or Circletoons, and it came from a tiny black bullet point that I just thought was funny one day. It was nearly a decade ago, and it's now evolved into my life. And I really gotta thank you guys for that. You guys have given me the life and the career that I've always wanted and I've always worked towards. I seriously couldn't do, you know, anything like this without your guys' support. And, you know, it was always my biggest dream to have a career and a life in art, in animation specifically. And now I get to do that because of you guys. And I know that's kind of what everyone says, where, you know, it's like, I wouldn't be here without you guys. But it's a fact. I would not be here doing what I want to do without you guys. This year, 2020, I'm going to be a featured creator at VidCon. And I hope I get to meet a million of you guys, and we can take all the photos and make amazing memories. But that was always one of my biggest dreams, even, you know, years ago when I was just making comics and posting them on Facebook. It was one of my biggest dreams to be a featured creator at a huge convention. And we're gonna do that this year because of you guys. Everything on this channel, all the laughter, all the dumb videos and comics and merch and every single thing you can think of, you have yourself to thank for that. And I'm eternally grateful. And I'm sorry if this video isn't some crazy, you know, jumping out of an airplane and throwing pencils at a million houses celebration. I don't fucking know. Something crazy. I'm sorry that this is not that, but I felt like I kind of owed it to you guys to just speak from the damn heart, from the thing that pumps blood in me, and just talk to you guys and just show my appreciation, because this is my life and I love you guys. So, fuck it. You know what? I'm just gonna, like, write the word thank you in paint, and I'm just gonna copy and paste it. I'm gonna try to copy and paste it a million times, and we'll see if it destroys my computer. This might actually, like, explode my computer, but we will see what happens. Thank you, guys. Okay, so this makes 10. That's 10. Now we got 100. Just gonna click it up in there. There we go. That is 100 thank yous. Oh god, look how laggy it is. This is only 1,000. So, a little problem. This is only 1,000 thank yous, and this is as far as paint enlarges. So we're gonna have to go into a more powerful program. Okay, this is not gonna work. There's no fucking way. Look at this. So I copied a 4,000, and when I scroll over here, it's like, bwah, bwah. What the hell is happening? This shit is fucky wucky. Look, and this is 10,000, right? But the more I bring it to the right, the more it like breaks, and then it builds itself back. What the hell is happening? So this is 100,000. At least it's trying to be, and then it's like, I think I've really pushed Adobe to its limits. Look what happens when I try to draw a line. It does some shit, dude. Go, we're almost there!
One final thank you. There we go. 1 million!
What the hell?